Thank you for joining us on this Saturday night. I'm Chris Negus. A spike in coronavirus cases means more restrictions for struggling businesses in the Metro East. Here are the latest numbers. The state of Illinois reported more than 6,100 new coronavirus cases just over the last 24 hours. That is the highest daily total so far. The statewide positivity rate in Illinois is also increasing and now stands at 6.1%. In the Metro East, the positivity rate is even higher than that at 8.2%, leading to new restrictions. It was the news thousands of people in the Metro East did not want to hear, with the number of positive cases going up in Region 4, which includes Madison and St. Clair counties. Tighter restrictions are expected to go into place on Wednesday. Ray Preston has been talking with business owners about the setback.
It was just 2 weeks ago, October 9th, when they allowed indoor dining once again. Here at Joe's Pizza and Pasta, they put up the sign, "Welcome back, come on in. We are so excited to see you." But apparently it looks like now indoor dining will be something that is pretty short-lived.
Saturday night and cars are pulling up for curbside pickup. Sandy Glick is getting dinner.
A medium pizza, sausage and pepperoni. They have the best pizzas in town.
While you can eat inside now, it's expected on Wednesday it will once again be banned.
Yeah, I hate to think that it might close back down again. But we got to be safe, you know. We wear a mask and when we're out and everything, and so it's, you know, we do the best we can.
Disappointed. I think we're getting lumped in with people we don't belong lumped in with, personally. I wish they'd do county by county.
St. Clair and Madison counties are in Region 4 with several other counties. Critics say even if a county is keeping its numbers down, if a nearby county's positivity rate climbs, neighboring counties suffer.
Because we're grouped with them, it hits us too. That's the bad part. I mean, Clinton County right now, I think, is
some dinner salads here.
Yeah, Region 4. Yeah, I mean, so even like, I know Clinton County is really bad right now. Jersey County is really bad. I think Bond County. We're all bigger, higher percentage than us, but because we fall in the same region, we're paying for it as well.
In the meantime, businesses are adapting the best they can. Some say they wouldn't be surviving without the community support.
With Belleville and Shiloh and Swansea and O'Fallon and Fairview Heights, all the families, all the community, all of our loyal supporters that have came here for years, they've stepped up since March, since we've been locked down. We've also gained a lot of new customers from it. Has it been hard still in day to day? Of course. But the support that we've had has been fantastic.
One restaurant owner says with no indoor dining, he figures he'll lose about 25% of his business. This is certainly not good news for a lot of the small restaurants and businesses that have been struggling for months now. In Fairview Heights, Ray Preston, News 4.
And as we mentioned, Illinois hit a record high in cases today. Health officials reported more than 6,100 new cases and 63 additional deaths since the outbreak began. Illinois has seen more than 370,000 cases and more than 9,400 deaths. In Missouri, nearly 3,000 new cases were reported today, but health officials say some of those cases stretch back to October 18th, and they did not happen over the last 24 hours. The state also reported a backlog of 113 additional deaths. Missouri now has more than 167,000 reported cases and 2,800 deaths. It's not just an increasing number of cases. The number of COVID patients hospitalized in the St. Louis area is also up. New hospital admissions increased to 66 today from 42 yesterday. There are currently more than 350 patients in the hospital with COVID-19 around the St. Louis area.